Hello. Welcome to Social Dissonance. This durational concert is happening both in Kassel and in Athens in the same time. I have to inform you that you are being filmed, and this film is going to be projected here tomorrow in this screen and uploaded on YouTube and on archive. So if you don't want to be filmed, I'm afraid you will have to leave right now. Also, there is another factor that it's preferable for us and for you to stay for the whole hour, for 1 hour, which is the time of the concert. If you cannot commit right now to stay for the whole time, it's better for you and for us to leave right now from the back door. And this is the only door you can use during the concert also, if you want to leave. But you will have to give us some feedback, so we'll learn from you also and improve. This is our score. You are invited to participate to help us interpreting this score. It's not an easy score, so we need you. And that's all. I forgot to say something. Please, if you can, speak one by one. It's because of the acoustics of this room, it's impossible to get out anything if we speak all together. We have to speak one by one.
You don't want to participate?
No, I'm going to go.
But why?
Trying to learn how to be a human being.
I want to learn to listen. I like Capri.
Yeah, one information that you want to share.
What I really would like to share is peace.
Peace.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Me too.
I'm just very curious what's going to happen.
Yes, I'm very nervous and excited about this performance.
There's a really good place to swim here, Kassel.
I would like to know where it is.
I'd like to be less bored.
I came here alone. I would like to understand more.
I would like to listen and to talk.
I would like to explore.
I would like to make some new friends.
I'm here while my husband is at home with my two children.
I'm very thirsty.
I'm skeptical of the collective subject.
Can you speak up a little bit,
please? Do you want me to repeat myself? I'm skeptical of the collective subject.
I would like to see the whole and things, the whole.
I would like that there is more love for animals.
I love musical scores.
I went on my first water slide 2 weeks ago, and I want to go on more.
I'd like to participate.
I'd like to explore the arts.
I wonder what my toddler is doing. I'm tired.
I prefer to be alone than in a relationship.
I have a cat named Dobby.
I like the fact that I'm very aware of my position right now.
I don't know what happened here.
I'm happy, but very nervous.
I like the clean forest.
I like traveling by ship. And now we would like to think about the other information that we didn't want to share. Why did we want to share it? And the feedback.
Would you like to share with us why you want to leave? Yes, that's a no.
Okay, but for the ones that stay, I want to make sure what we said in the introduction, that if you want to get in the middle, you have to give some feedback. Okay? So we're here, right? And okay, about the information that we didn't want to share.
What inspires us to speak or share amongst most people that we don't know? Enhances the complexity of our cloud or our body of feeling or perception. And in that space of unsureness or unfamiliarity, it's actually easier to grasp the things that you don't want to share, because those are also unfamiliar and hard to share.
Could you do it?
did not want to share that I'm self-conscious about my external identity as a white man from the United States, even though that is obvious. And so that I became more aware of that when I came into this space surrounded by people that I don't know.
I think I'm pressed for truth. I'm afraid to share that there is a lot of violence in me. I just thought a lot of time about the Third Reich and about Auschwitz. And the most horrible thought was not to be a victim, but to be to do it, to kill people like in Auschwitz, to save myself or to save my family. And this was the most horrible thought in my whole life. And how much violence is within me. And when I see the internet or things like this in the Times now, I'm really afraid about the violence in the world today. That's my most thing that I'm most thinking of.
I'm thinking about the setting here. You chose this special room. Taught us to tell us each other what we want to share, but the room is making it impossible to understand the other people. So I'm thinking, did you do this, how to say, do you think, is that the plan? Did you choose the room like this so that information and talking to one up and the other is impossible? Or is it just coming from kismet?
I also have problems to understand the other people. My English, I didn't know that it is in English. And I have some problems to understand it by acoustically and by the language.
The idea is to share a thought that you didn't want to share, or tell us why you didn't want to share this thought.
At the moment, I don't want to share my sadness with the other people.
I don't want to share intimacy.
Okay, so I propose that because it's difficult, the acoustics, as you said, I propose that we find one person in the room, we select one person that we don't know, and we tell only this person about our second thought, about the information we didn't want to use, why we didn't want to share this, or what is it, or I don't know, anything, something about that. But only to one person from the room, okay? That we don't know.
We together choose one.
Thank you.
can we leave?
Yes.
We were very open to the performance, but we hoped for like more performance from someone else. Like, yeah, it's a bit uncomfortable.
In participating.
Yes. So
why don't you try this? I mean,
I think we have got a very long day, so we've been like up since 7, and we're like, because we're here in a group, and we're on a group travel with like students, so I think that's why, but I'm not really feeling comfortable, so
yeah.
I'm like, but I really hope you enjoy it.
Okay.
So thank you.
Instead of that way.
Yes.
Okay. What if we had something that we gave to people that you had to have that if you wanted to share, if you wanted to speak?
Like a
folded up piece of the instructions.
To do what?
To speak. Because if we can only hear if.
Ah.
So that way the attention
follows
the data.
You can use the microphone, sir.
I'm just going to say one thing really quick. It's very easy to break off into separate individual conversations. So, we are going to make a small device, a folded up piece of paper. And if you wish to say something to the entire group, that this will be passed around and given to you, or you can like hold it up and say, I now want to share something with everybody, so that we all listen and don't have to use the microphone, which is fatal.
I think sharing the thing you don't want to share from the big group isn't it something like obeying the peer pressure, and I think maybe it's an act of disobedience of not sharing the thing you don't want to share.
I didn't want to share my opinion that I don't want to share here because it's going to be recorded and it's going to be in public. It's going to be in the internet and it's going to be out there forever.
And I just thought it's about doing our own thing as a group and not about fulfilling directions that we don't fulfill, so we just should not do it. Not talk about this theme because maybe there are more interesting things to do. So maybe we can just do something that's fun. But I don't have an idea.
Do you know a game?
But
maybe
as a way to move forward. Okay.
I'm proposing, sorry, the acoustics here are beautiful. I don't know if it's better if it's louder or more quietly. I'm suggesting that we read the score that the artist prepared for this situation, for this performance, as a way of trying to understand the situation that we're in. But I wanted us to vote on the idea to make sure that that's something that we want to do with this situation. So I'm not sure, but I don't know how to count the number of people. Do you, as the moderators, want to help? Maybe we can have the vote again and you can decide.
Let's separate in two categories.
Okay,
people who want to do
idea.
It from there and don't want to do that from the mission.
So if you want to, if you want us to read the score, go to this side of the room.
If you don't want the score read, you should go to that side of the
room. Yeah.
So how should we read the score?
Is it okay for you if we read the score?
Okay. Well, maybe we can form a circle again, because now we're, it's just an
undemocratic
situation.
No, we can make a circle, it would be exclusion.
No, I think we should make a circle again, so we understand that you don't want to read the score.
Is it okay if we read the score and you are in a circle?
Oh yeah, that's a great idea. We should have a reader in English and a reader in German.
Other languages.
Well, yes, that's true. Maybe I'll start with the first line and then I'll pass it around in English. And if there are people who want to translate, or there's a German handout also, so we can continue in German after. Okay, so to avoid making this too complicated, maybe since I'm speaking English right now,
we also haven't decided if English should be the language of our administration, so to speak.
Yeah, well, maybe we ask if someone doesn't understand English. Yeah. Maybe they would have left already. I don't know. I didn't mean to take a leadership role here. Let's see. Is there anyone who does not know? We can ask them. Without getting too wrapped up in this, I'm going to begin reading the score, and I'm going to pass it around, and maybe everyone who is on this side of me can read a line. And it just seems to me that this might be the most interesting way of moving forward with this situation, instead of... Well, I don't know. It seems like this is the one thing that brought us here together in some way.
Maybe we can make it 5 hours because the school is special with the acoustics. We have to use the acoustics.
So what should we do?
See, we have a choir together. Yeah. Maybe we need to
I don't want to.
Probably read it first, maybe in English and in German, and if anybody speaks Greek, because those seem to be languages here, and then we can move forward, like you're saying, from there. Do you want to start with the English first?
So maybe I'll begin with the title, Social Dissonance.
Listen carefully. The audience is your instrument. Play it in order to practically understand how we are generally instrumentalized.
Prepare the audience with concepts,
questions, movements as a way to explore the dissonance that exists between the individual narcissism that capitalism promotes and our social capacity, between how we conceive ourselves as free individuals with agency and the way that we are socially determined by capitalist relations, technology, and ideology.
Reflect on the I-we relation while defining social dissonance.
How the collective is beginning to emerge.
May I propose a vote? How many people would like to now hear it in your head? So how many people would like to hear the score in German?
Can they maybe go to this one?
Sure. Score in German? Come on over here.
Ah, you.
Yeah. You want to hear
gesellschaftliche Dissonanz.
Hört gut zu. Das Publikum ist euer Instrument. Spielt es, um zu verstehen, wie wir grundsätzlich instrumentalisiert werden.
Versorgt das Publikum mit Konzepten, Fragen und Bewegungen.
Und erforscht dadurch die Dissonanz, die zwischen dem individuellen vom Kapitalismus hervorgebrachten Narzissmus und unserer sozialen Fähigkeit existiert.
Die Dissonanz zwischen der Art und Weise, wie wir uns selbst als freie Individuen mit Handlungsmacht wahrnehmen und der, wie wir durch kapitalistische Beziehungen, Technologie und Ideologie gesellschaftlich bestimmt werden.
Denkt über die Beziehung zwischen dem Ich und Wir nach, wenn ihr die gesellschaftliche Dissonanz bestimmt.
Helft dem kollektiven Subjekt dabei zu entstehen.
What do you guys think about maybe sharing some concepts or maybe some questions that you guys might, that we all might have, so that we can start to explore the dissonance following rule number three? I mean, it's part of the score number three. If anybody wants to do...
I think the main question is, what's dissonance?
What is dissonance?
What's dissonance? I mean, is it disobedience? Is it like not forming a harmony? And so, do we have to strive for dissonance? Or just the opposite? Do we have to form a group? Or do we have to become individuals?
Help the collective subject to emerge.
So we have to form a group. We have to do something collective.
I think the question is, how are we being instrumentalized at the moment in this performance?
Are we? So we are. So now we have set ourselves apart from the performers, that we're doing like other things now, like reading the score. Are we now being instrumentalized or the opposite? So
if we wanted to discuss this without being recorded at all times, and also so that more voices could be heard, we could discuss it in smaller groups. And since there's only one camera, we would only be recorded part of the time. And I also just think, in general, maybe there are other people who want to speak but don't want to speak in front of the whole group.
Very good. This could also solve the acoustic problem.
Yeah, so that's an idea. I mean, so maybe here's a thought. If you feel like forming a small group with other people, why don't you do that now? And if you don't want to, you can do something other than that.
My problem is sometimes I don't know who is in the team. Where is your team? You and you and you and perhaps you and perhaps you.
I think we have to do something as a collective and not separate ourselves.
What? There is
a
name.
Ah,
the name of the team. There I can find it.
If they don't, we are. If we others don't want to say.
Well.
Difficult to hear, and maybe if people prefer to speak in other languages, they can do this out loud. So, I don't know, so that's an idea.
Does everyone agree to go into smaller groups?
Yeah.
Well, but actually, if people don't want to form a small group, they can just do something else.
Okay.
Discussed in a small group. I mean, it's just the whole purpose of the small groups is to increase the effectivity of communication and take off the pressure of speaking in front of a larger group, which some people might feel. So that's a great question.
But what's it about here? Is it about communication in small groups, or is it about how a big group works? I think it's about how we work as a big group.
But what if, in order for the big group to function, it needs to break into, it might help it to work, break into smaller groups?
I've observed that in the time that's elapsed already, that pretty much there are very few people are talking in relation to the larger situation, including me, obviously.
Yeah. There is a viewer here that is asking, can you repeat the question?
He was asking if the online audience is an audience that we have to consider also.
In the groups.
Because if we start having different groups, the online audience is cancelled, like they won't be able to understand anything.
Yeah.
Can they contact
them?
That's
the reason, right?
Yeah, yes. They're human.
Can they answer us?
Yes, they write comments.
Thanks. Come here, you can.
Minus Plato 1.
Hello.
Can you see
I thought it was broadcasted only later, not live.
It's live.
It's live? Did you say that?
Acoustic, but don't want to split in groups, maybe we should stop talking and maybe try to communicate differently.
Can we ask them how many they are?
You can type a comment. You can use a chat. Να κάνουμε explore. Τι θέλουμε. Sorry, can we ask why we took out the plug?
Well, technically I didn't do it.
It was me.
Why?
It seemed like people objected to being filmed, which I realize we still are.
It seemed like a way to move the situation forward.
Do you think it helped?
Unclear as of yet.
Yeah, I just decided to take an action. In fact, I'm considering unplugging the rest of it, too. Because this is an experiment, right? It's an experiment to see what people do under pressure and in a room.
My opinion is different, but I'm not sure either. I have very slight instructions about what I have to do here.
Yeah.
What are your instructions?
What I have done until now, but my idea about what we are doing here is that we are trying to be comfortable in a very uncomfortable situation. try to figure out how we can be collectively together.
But while there are a lot of problems. But I think that the fact that you're filming everybody, I realize it's part of your instructions, but I think that's inhibiting the goal.
But that's also make you think like about privacy and like we put very intimate stuff on social media and things like that. And
I guess I don't.
are you guys being paid as performers?
Yes.
How much are you being paid?
1,200 euros per month.
Okay.
Do you think that that's enough?
That's okay because we steal the taxes. We get paid by a cryptocurrency.
By what?
Cryptocurrency, fair coin.
Huh.
So there's
what?
No taxes. Can you explain what that is?
There's no taxes.
Yes.
Is it like Bitcoin? I just don't
Very
care.
Similar, but more fair.
Okay.
How much do you earn a month?
Are you Maybe. Guys from Greece or from Germany? Or?
From Athens.
From Athens, yeah.
Ah, yes.
How much do
what
you
do you think about Documenta being in Castle in Athens?
It's gonna be
how
a different.
How much do you earn a month?
I'm not
I'll
sure.
Say, I earn 2,500
wow.
USD.
What do you do?
I'm a PhD student.
Okay. What do you write your PhD about?
Performance.
And do you think this is a good performance?
It's unclear still.
Okay.
But I think dissonance more so than harmony.
But we use like democratic structures,
yeah.
And the result is dissonance. Maybe that's an interesting thing to
yeah.
think about.
Yeah.
To reflect about.
And perhaps like the democratic ideal is impossible to achieve.
The thing where I'm curious about, and that's the interesting thing, the other groups will also be online, is how the other groups react in this situation.
But to me, these to conclude in that. The democracy is unable to happen because we 50 people could not communicate
no,
in doing.
I don't think that's
Sorry.
The right conclusion. Because
just a moment, can I?
Yeah.
Thank you. Because, like, for the people that were here couldn't weren't able to communicate in what to do in 1 hour. I think this is not a good conclusion, or this is not how it leads. This does not lead to the other, but it leads to the question why we couldn't do that. And we are specific humans, that we are raised in capitalism and we are raised in, I don't know, with an ideology that is this ideology that we have, and with the notions and the everyday life of individuals and... Yeah, we're not so comfortable in being together and trying to form a group and do something collectively without having one person to tell us what to do or stuff like that. So maybe this is the question, and that's why I asked you, why do you want to do something funny? Because I thought that I understood that you wanted to do it because the situation is uncomfortable, but to me it is very interesting to question ourselves why the situation is so uncomfortable. Because structurally, it's not a so uncomfortable situation. We are 40 people in a room that, okay, we don't know everybody, maybe we know one or two people, or I don't know, but we can do anything we want. Structurally, it shouldn't be or feel so uncomfortable. Why is it?
The privacy issue. Maybe we should reflect on privacy.
Yeah.
Maybe we don't want to have all our decision-making processes or all our intimate thoughts to be shared ethically. And so we have to think about the link between privacy and democracy and privacy and feeling ourselves comfortable.
Because you're, if you want to leave, you're forced to tell mm-hmm. why you're uncomfortable, or that you're uncomfortable and why you want to leave. So these are two things that make very uncomfortable.
And it's so uncomfortable to share why you want to leave.
No, it's uncomfortable to be in front of this, to have to. You're filming me right now, so this is uncomfortable for me. I tell you, go on, because I agreed that I'm going to be filmed, of course, but that's making it uncomfortable because I don't share it only with you people, but I don't know who else I will share it with. If it's gonna be people that are gonna be weird things about me and stuff. So that's what
I think reflecting on this arts project, it's not uncomfortable to be in a room with 40 people. And if you wouldn't have pushed it in a certain direction, it could have maybe the experiment would be more true.
but you pushed it in a certain direction that made the situation uncomfortable. So it's not true, because we could not find out what would really happen if 40 people are in a room and they don't have anything. It would be more true if you just sit in the room and then you say, go for it. And then we could have more
go for what?
Experience. Go for whatever you want to do as a group.
But we're always being pushed. You have to take off your backpack and buy a ticket to come into Documenta, and they say you can't do this or that. You wait to cross the street. So perhaps there's no time in which you're not being told what to do.
Yes, but she said, why is it an uncomfortable situation? Because we are human beings and it could be a comfortable situation with 40 people in a group. So I say this saying of you is not true, because you pushed it in this direction. And maybe if she hadn't pushed it, it would have been another situation for us human beings as a group in this room.
But we are acting very much on the level of language.
For me, the thing that makes it really uncomfortable is that they experience this outside reality that constructs the space in a certain way, that it doesn't permit people to be themselves all the time. So there is this problem that they would like to be themselves, they want to make fun, they want to be transmit their cultural capital, have the same as they have outside. But here, some of them, they get it and they see this contradiction, and this is why it feels so uncomfortable, I think. But the people who manage to speak, actually, I don't think they actually feel so uncomfortable. Like, after a while, they get used to it and they do speak, so they just complain about it. Because the real people that they are uncomfortable are out there, outside of the circle, I think. And they are apart, outside of this small circle we made. So these are the most uncomfortable people, I believe.
Having something to do is something that's sort of programmed into our understanding of perception and navigating on a day-to-day basis. And maybe some people wanted to don't like that part, aren't comfortable with that part of themselves either. They wanted to question that. There were some people who didn't wanted to question it. Immediately the attack of the attention was on the setup, was on the why, was on the instrumentalization on what we were doing.
She said it before, but we were also instrumentalized.
Right.
And then why should we be free in this room? And also, if we tell you, you're free to do whatever you want, you know what?
Right. No one does anything. People imprison themselves.
Yeah, no one does anything. Yeah. So we try to enable them to start, to move, to make a certain start with 2 or 3 ideas.
And I think we got a thing to do. People get and then this thing had in it somewhere the part that wanted to attack the thing itself. So it's sort of like, as it started, it also attacked, it also created
something.
And you forgot at the beginning to say that it is in English.
I thought it was also in English.